Welcome back, everybody. Third quarter just about to get going here in what has been so far a runaway game.
Lillard has been playing really well. 10 points, and he's picked up 6 points from behind the arc.
Now his outside stroke has looked really good today.
Trailblazers leading by 18.
Well, Blazers coach Terry Stotts is a branch on the tree of head coach George Karl, and that's a pretty good tree to be on. In his playing days, Karl coached Stotts in the CBA, and actually Stotts had a pretty good career in Europe.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade for the second half of basketball. On the court for Atlanta, Jeff Teague and Lou Williams, the back. Millsap at power forward with Horford at center. And it's Korver in at the small forward position. Here comes Damian Lillard. Outside Matthews. He feeds it to Aldridge. That one off the back iron and out. The Hawks trail by 18. Williams kicks to T. Williams has a screen for T. Tries again, and Horford finishes inside.
He got a great read of where that miss was going, and that allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
And for Terry Stotts, after his playing days, he coached as an assistant under George Karl, both in the CBA and then with the Sonics and the Bucks.
And over 2 decades of coaching experience, Kevin. This is his 6th season overall as an NBA head coach. Remember, he coached the Hawks as well as the head man. But I thought did a nice job with Portland last season.
Well, you know, everybody figured that it was going to be Anthony Davis running away with the Rookie of the Year last season, guys. But right from the start, I mean out of the chute, Damian Lillard showed that he was going to be making a serious push to receive that Rookie of the Year honor.
Well, you talk about the hot start for Damian Lillard. He reached 400 points and 140 assists in 22 games. Only 3 players in NBA history have reached that mark in 22 games or less.
It's incredible the way you pull that stuff off the top of your head.
I know.
You know who the numbers, the other players were?
I bet it's some pretty good names.
Yeah, Oscar Robertson, Isaiah Thomas, and Allen Iverson.
That's pretty good.
I pulled that off the top of my head.
That's your lofty company. Sure. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation. Portland leading by 19. Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over.
Wes Matthews was undrafted out of Marquette back in 2009. But he ended up not only making the team in Utah, but starting as a rookie for the Jazz. He solidified himself as a quality wing in this league. And he's a tough defender who can make the outside shot. And you always know what you're going to get from him at both ends of the floor.
Let's find out what Doris Burke has for us.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Terry Stotts as he addressed his team. The ball has to be fed into the low post much more than it has been to this point. That was his message. He said, they're giving us room down low. Let's take advantage of it. There was one other thing he talked to them about. He told them to move with purpose on the perimeter, use screens, and find those open outside shots. Probably a good time to make some changes with a good chunk of the second half still to go, Kevin.
Thank you, Doris. Lillard dishes to Batum. He's looking for Lopez and finds him. And it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for him. And Clark, you talked about the toughness for Wes Matthews until last season. You know, Steve, he had never missed a game.
250 straight games to start his career. He's battled through pain to always try to get the job done for his teammates. One of my favorite players in the league. Just a tough, physical player who can knock down threes. Somebody you want on your squad.
His dad played in the NBA for a while.
That's right.
And Kyle Korver picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
Yeah, you know, these calls can be some of the toughest in the game for the officials.
It all happened so fast, but I really think that was the right call. The defender was not really set in that situation.
Schroeder, he's checked in for Atlanta. Now here is Aldridge. He's got 10. Lillard, the pass to Batum. And Matthews kicks to Lillard. Shot clock at 5. Fires from 18. And he hits the jumper for 2. Lillard's got 15 points.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
Here's Schroeder, covered by Lillard. Plenty of space. Korver, good. Korver's got his second basket.
Boy, he made a nice little bounce pass there. We call that the pocket pass, and he did it well.
Williams against Matthews. Pass to Lopez. And the pass to Lillard. He kicks it to Batum. He dishes it to Matthews. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got three rebounds so far in the game. He passes it to Korver. It's up a three. Damian Lillard grabs the loose ball. Trailblazers leading by 19 points. Pass to Matthews. 1:46 left in the third. Portland needs to get off the shot. Three-pointer, Lillard. Trailblazers keep it alive. The Hawks trail by 19. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
And a look here at the most accurate shooting guards in the NBA this season. Wesley Matthews on top.
Now, he's not a wasteful player. I mean, that much we've learned. He makes the most of the good looks he gets. And if it's not there, he's not going to force a bad shot.
But you know what, Steve? It's not all about shot selection. Let's not overlook what an unbelievable shooter he is, period. I mean, he can knock him down from all over the court with defenders draped all over him.
And he knocks down the first one. And the Hawks will go for a different look here. And good on the second, so he makes them both. Portland leading by 17. Williams with the ball, now guarded by Schroeder. Williams dishes to Robinson. Right side Robinson on the wing, Batum. Jacks up a three, and he gets it to go. Batum's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball. The Hawks trail by 20. Millsap a screen on Williams. There's 48 seconds left here in the third quarter. Jenkins the pass to Brink. Nice ball movement here by Atlanta. Here's Schroeder. And once again off the mark by Atlanta.
You know, so many games are decided by which team wins the rebound battle. And that's held true in this one so far, Steve.
And even if it's only a modest advantage that they have in that category, it's still a significant factor.
Now here's Williams. Feeds it to Wright. Takes a three. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Williams.
That's two bombs in a row from long range.
Yeah, shoddy defense there. Far too slow to react on the closeouts.
Schroeder kicks to Jenkins. Millsap off a pick from Jenkins. From downtown, and that one's good. Schroeder's got 5 points now this quarter.
This is great. Three-pointers going down quickly at both ends.
Yeah, it took them no time to answer back on that possession.
The three quarters of play all in the books, and this one all but over already. Portland out in front, delivering the blowout. And we're just moments away from the start of the fourth quarter. Stay with us.
Tune in next Wednesday, November 27th. Tim Duncan and the San Antonio Spurs take on Kevin Durant and the Oklahoma City Thunder. Be there.
How about a look at today's State Farm assist of the game?
Yeah, let's do it. I love the way this play developed. He took what looked like a difficult pass and turned it into an easy basket.